In this session, I'm going to discuss about checksum. Checksum is the error detection technique that can be applied to the message of any length, especially for larger length. Most of the time, this is performed in network layer and transport layer instead of data link layer. As you see in this diagram, the sender divides the original message into different blocks. Each block contains m number of bits. Using a generator, extra m bits are generated and that will be appended to the original message. So this extra m bit generated using a generator is called as a checksum. So this will be transmitted to the receiver. The receiver extracts the checksum and also the original bits, and using the checking mechanism, it checks for all zeros. If the resultant is all zeros, then the original message is accepted. Otherwise, it will be discarded. Considering this example, I will explain in a simple way. In this example, there are totally 5 blocks, 7, 11, 12, 0 and 6, they have taken into decimal number. In the sender side, it will be added and the resultant will be 36. Then take the 1's complement of that. Let us consider it as minus 36. Minus 36 now is the checksum, hence append that to the message. So last will be minus 36. So this is forwarded to the receiver. Receiver will again add all the m bits along with the checksum. So here 7 plus 11 plus 12 plus 0 plus 6 plus minus 36, that will be 0. Hence it is accepted. Let us consider now how it is performed using bits. Add all the m bit blocks. Here m will be 4, that means each block has 4 bits. Hence we write each block into 4 number of bits. Add all the values. We get the sum as 0110. We have to take 1's complement of this, that will be 1001. This is the checksum that will be forwarded to the receiver along with the original message. Receiver again adds all the m bits along with the checksum, and the resultant will be the sum, that will be 1111. Take the 1's complement of that, that will be 0000, hence it is accepted. Here is the second example. There are totally 4 blocks, each block contain m bits, m is equal to 8 here. This is the sum. Then take the checksum as 1's complement of the sum. In the receiver, again add all the k number of blocks and checksum. Add the checksum. This is the final sum. Do the 1's complement of this. You are going to get zeros. Then the message is accepted. Here is the procedure to calculate the traditional checksum. That is, in internet today, how is checksum calculated? Here each block is considered as 16-bit words. this is the flowchart of how checksum is calculated. In addition to the basic methodology, there are two more approaches in checksum calculation. First one is Fletcher checksum mechanism. Here there are two basic types. First type is to have checksum of 16 bits. Second type is to have checksum of 32 bits. In first type, there are 8 bit blocks are created, and in second type, 16 bit blocks are created to summarize the 32 bit checksum. Second methodology of calculation of checksum, that is Adler checksum. Here the resultant checksum will be of 32 bit. This is the algorithm for 8 bit Fletcher checksum. L left 8 bit, R right 8 bit, DI is the next 8 bit data item. The resultant checksum here you are going to get is 16 bit checksum. Note that 256 is taken as modulus number to calculate left and right part of the checksum. You know why? Yes, 2 to the power 8 is equal to 256. Suppose if you are considering 16 bit Fletcher, the resultant will be 32 bit checksum. Here the modulo will be 65536, because 2 to the power 16 is equal to 65536. This is the algorithm for Adler checksum. It is similar to 16 bit Fletcher checksum with the three differences. First one, calculation is done on single byte instead of two bytes at the same time. Second, the modulus is a prime number. And third one is L is initialized to 1 instead of 0. Why the modulus number is a prime number? Because it is proved that a prime modulo has a better detecting capability in some combinations of data.